plant classification. Plant classification was given by Eckler. Plants are the multicellular living beings. They are autotrophs in their nature and multicellular. In this classification, or according to this classification, the plant kingdom divided into two groups, or plants are divided into two groups. First, cryptogams, or first subkingdom is called as cryptogams, and second subkingdom is called the phanerogams. Used for this classification. So first thing is here, these plants are seedless. There is no seed in these plants. Flowerless. There is no flowers. These plants are seedless, flowerless, no fruits, fruitless. It means these plants are green, autotrophs. They can perform the photosynthesis, but they having no seed, no flower, no fruits. So first of all, what is the meaning of crypto? Crypto, it means hidden. They having the hidden sex organs. What is the meaning of crypto? Crypto, it means they are having the hidden sex organs. While in the case of phanerogams, phanerogams are the plants which having the seeds. Phanero, it means these plants are having the open sex organs. They having the open sex organs. And gams, it means marries. So in this type of classification, we discuss about the two groups or two subkingdoms of the plants. So first of all, we discuss about the cryptogams. What are the cryptogams? First subkingdom, cryptogams. Cryptogams are the plants which are seedless, fruitless. So these plants also categorize in following groups. First, we call it thallophytes. Second, bryophytes. And third one, we call them pteridophytes. These all plants are seedless. There is no seeds, no fruit, and no flowers. In all the plants, these type of structures are absent in all three categories of the plants. First of all, we discuss about the thallophytes. What is the meaning of thallophytes? Thallophytes are the plants which having the thallus-like plant body. So first of all, what is the meaning of thallus? Thallus-like plant body. Thallus, it means bag-like structure. Thallus, it means bag-like structure. Bag-like structure, we call it them thallus. Plant body. What is the meaning of plant body? First of all, plant body, it means as we know, if suppose we call a plant or an animal, an image is formed in our mind. Plant means it having the leaf, root, and stem in their structure. Suppose if you are discuss about the animal having the mouth, head, tail, leg, hands. These are the structure of an animal, and these are the structure of plant. But in these plants, in thallophytes, there is no leaf, no root, and no stem. So these plants are without leaf, without root, and stem. So such type of structure is known as the thallus, and these plants are called the thallophytes. The plants which are without root, stem, and leaf are called the thallophytes. So we discuss about the thallophytes here. Thallophytes further categorized in the subgroups. First, we call it the algae. Second one, we call them fungi. And third one, we call them lichens. These all the living beings and all the plants having no seed, no flowers, no fruits in their structure, they having thallus like plant. So first of all, we discuss about the algae. Algae are the autotrophs. Autotrophs, it means they can synthesize their own food, and they are multicellular as well as they are aquatic in nature. Aquatic, it means they are present in the water, in both type of water. First, fresh water. Fresh, it means river water, pond water, lake water. So this is known as the fresh water. And another is marine water or salty water. So this type of algae is present in the both type of habitat. So we call them aquatic habitat. They are found in the aquatic habitat. They are the multicellular. They are the green in color, or they are the autotrophs due to the presence of the pigments, chlorophyll pigments. These chlorophyll pigments are responsible for the photosynthesis in the algae. So they are having the chlorophyll pigments inside it. Chlorophyll pigments are present in the chloroplast, so they are found in the algaeoles. So this cellulogenol is responsible for the photosynthesis in the plants. In the algae, some are the unicellular also. They are the multicellular as well as some are the unicellular also. And algae, this type of algae having the eukaryotic cellular organization. They are having the eukaryotic cells. While some algae having the prokaryotic cell organization also, we call them cyanobacteria. In some algae, like cyanobacteria, we call them blue-green algae. They are having the prokaryotic unicellular cell organization. So this type of arrangement or this type of organization is present in the algae. Algae having the sex organs, it shows the sexual reproductions as well as asexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction, it means the sex organs are present for the reproduction, while some spores are present in the algae for asexual reproduction. Some example of this type of algae is, first of all, we have discussed about the prokaryotic algae, it means blue-green algae. Blue-green algae or cyanobacteria, they are also algae, but they are the prokaryotic in nature, so we consider it in the Monera group. But in the clear classification, it is classified in this kingdom or in this subkingdom. Examples of the blue-green algae is the Nostoc and Abina. These are the some examples of blue-green algae. Examples, cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria are the prokaryotic cell or prokaryotic structure, which is called the blue-green algae also. For example, this is also called the BGA. For example, first Nostoc and Abina. These are some blue-green algae which having the prokaryotic organization. Now, about the green algae or eukaryotic algae, so they are categorized in the some groups. We call them green algae also. So green algae are the Spirogyra, Eulothrix. These are the scientific name of the algae, Cara, and some are the red algae, brown algae. So these are the some examples of algae which is multicellular, colonial or eukaryotic cellular organization. The some important feature of this algae is, these algae are the plants, so they are having their cell wall in their cell. They are having their cell wall, which is made up of cellulose. They are having their cell wall, which is made up of cellulose. They are having their stored food material. We call them starch. stored food. We call it starch. So these are some features of the algae. Now we discuss about the fungi. Second group of thallophyte, we call them fungi. Fungi is also multicellular plants as well as unicellular, but they are the non-green plants. It means they are not green in color or they have no chlorophyll pigment in their structure. Plants, it means they having no chlorophyll in their structure. No chlorophyll, it means they cannot synthesize their own food, so they are the heterotroph in the nature. It means they depend on other living being for food. Generally, fungi having the saprophytic mode of nutrition or parasitic mode of nutrition. Now, what are the main features of the fungi? They having the stored food is glycogen. While in the plant, they having the stored food is starch. Second one, they having cell wall, but it made up of chitin. Generally, in the plant cell, the cell wall is made up of cellulose, but in the case of fungi, it made up of chitin. Fungi also perform the sexual reproduction. It having the sexual structures for reproduction. Its plant body is made up of mycelium. Mycelium are the thread-like structure which is form the fungi, or it is called the fungi plant body. This plant body is made up of hyphae. This plant body is made up of hyphae, and this hyphae or hypha are the structure of the fungi. Some examples of the fungi are rhizopus. Examples: rhizopus, agaricus. Agaricus is the very common fungi which is used for the food. We call it the mushroom also. So mushroom is the fungi we use as a vegetable. And another important fungi we know, that is the penicillium, which is used for the production of an antibiotic, penicillin. So penicillium is a fungi which is used for the production of penicillin. Penicillin is the antibiotic or a medicine. So these are the fungi, and the association of fungi and algae is called the lichens. So lichen is the another type of living being. They are present in the living world. This is the association of algae and fungi. It means algae and fungi combined is known as the lichen. The algal part of this fungi is called the phycobiome. Phyco word is related with the algae. Phycology is the study of algae. The study of algae. While the fungi part is called the mycobiome. Mycobiont means myco. Mycology is the study of fungi. These two words are used for the lichen. Lichens are present or are found where? Lichens are found as the in natural environment or in the forest where the no living beings are present. The lichens are the first living beings. They develop on the rocks. What is the role of lichen? Lichens are the indicators of SO2 pollution. Indicator of SO2, sulfur dioxide pollution. If any area which having the pollution of sulfur dioxide, the lichens cannot survive there. So if any area which having no lichen in their surrounding, it means there is sulfur dioxide is present. So we call it the lichens are the pollution indicator, as well as they are the SO2 indicators. Some examples of lichens are, they are very typical, but Parmelia and Electoria. Thanks and have a nice day.